Could LDN be used with once weekly Ozempic, perhaps on different days far apart? I just heard the discussion about careful use of LDN with biologics. I have fibromyalgia, arthritis, and diabetes type 2, want to exercise, but I need to be in a lot less pain to do so. I hear you, girl. I absolutely, that is kind of the chicken before the egg kind of thing, right? It's hard to make changes in your lifestyle when you are in so much pain. So low-dose naltrexone, if you've been on Ozempic for quite some time, or I'm going to say even 6 months, I think it would be okay, but you'd need to be cautious about starting low-dose naltrexone. And this is why, is because low-dose naltrexone could perhaps change your blood glucose levels, and you don't want to get too low. Right? So usually with Ozempic, we see changes in hemoglobin A1Cs. They come down with time. If you're type 2, you know, I think one of the best A1Cs is to be at 5.5 or less. That's not always attainable right off the bat. It's going to take some time. But whenever you introduce a new medication, like what Sam was alluding to earlier, you've got to be cautious. And that means really pay attention, hone in as to what's going on with your body so that you can take stock in those changes and those symptoms. If you're not careful about anti-inflammatory diets, so for example, even with diabetes type 2, a lot of times there's a dysbiosis in the gut. Perhaps you don't have enough acromantia, which is the one specific bacterium in the gut that most diabetics are very low in. Metformin works on the acromantia bacteria to help metabolize as well. So we need to really pay attention to the foods that are being taken in and the timing of those, because that's what can cause different spikes in blood glucose levels. So really watching simple carbohydrates, making sure that you're fueling your body rather than just feeding the bad guys that are in your gut. That in itself, you will see a change in your fibromyalgia. You'll see a change in your arthritis, and you'll see a lot less pain. Because if you pay attention to what is actually going on in your gut, that will change a lot of issues. Now, some medications used for fibromyalgia, arthritis, diabetes, etc., and even some of the other comorbidities that we're concerned about, like cholesterol levels and depression, they can actually lead to, if not cause, a micronutrient deficiency. So magnesium is the first thing that I think of, because most people are deficient in magnesium in certain areas of the globe anyway. And magnesium is a natural muscle relaxer. Magnesium goes into the cell, it relaxes. Calcium goes into the cell, it contracts. So perhaps that's the other thing that's going on and why you don't feel maybe the energy, let alone the decrease in pain. But I have seen low-dose naltrexone work well with once weekly Ozempic. I have seen weight loss happen with the use of both of those medications. Just need to be cautious. And I think that is probably prudent advice, no matter what medication you're dealing with, whether it's low dose naltrexone or not.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. Yeah. Can I just add something on with this? What I would tend to say is probably best to take maybe a sublingual solution rather than the normal solution that we normally prescribe. Purely because in my clinical experience, people that have been on Ozempic or any type of glutide like that for diabetes, they tend to have a bit of an upset stomach to begin with. So in order not to have that compounded with LDN solution, I would tend to advise a sublingual solution for that. I don't know what you guys think about that.
Yeah, you can always add a little B6 or a little B12, and that'll help with the nausea too. But yes, that's a very, very, very good point.
Mm-hmm. The B6, yeah. So that's another thing that you would be compounding. You could do an LDN with a B6 element to it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Right. Okay. That's great.